Points of Departure was a way to think about how to deal with contemporary art for people who aren't used to seeing contemporary art.
There are a few things we're trying to do here. One of them was to create a prototype for the gallery and the exhibition of the future.
We wanted to experiment with ways that we could install the permanent collection, and we also wanted to experiment with ways we could invite viewers to engage works of art.
The second half of the title, Connecting with Contemporary Art, there we wanted people to make a connection between, you know, what they're seeing, what they're thinking about, and what's actually in the art.
You know, a lot of it seems to be challenging me, and I'm trying to come up with an idea as to what it tries to sort of represent.
What makes Points of Departure really different for us is that we chose to do a thematic installation. Each of six rooms had a theme that we organized the works of art in.
It was an interesting way to present works that would not otherwise be shown together as a common theme.
Well, I like the way it's clustered into segments.
From a curatorial standpoint, probably one of the most radical things we did in the show was to put computers actually in the galleries. And creating this exhibition was really a way to create a sort of experimental space that the museum could use to see how far do we want to go. How close to the works of art do we want to have the computers?
Well, I really definitely like the multimedia interaction of having the different computer TV displays around and have the opportunity to see what the different artists have to say about their pieces. I thought that was really enlightening.
We supplement wall text with smart tables, which are kind of a curator in a box in each gallery, which you have a succession of shortcuts and short takes given by the curators about why they put those artworks in that gallery, why those artists were interested in those problems, and some of the varieties of approaches the artists have taken in the artworks in that gallery. The idea behind the smart table is to give visitors access to information about the artworks just in time, at the moment when they need it, right there in the gallery.
No, John Cage.
All right, I mixed them up. So we're talking about trophies.
Someone's talking about an artwork, and the second they make a point about the artwork, you see it on screen next to you, and that artwork is actually right there in the gallery with you. So you can turn around, you can take your audio wand, you can look at the artwork and see it that way, and connect it a second time.
That all sound is music.
And really kind of triangulate each of the points that are made as they go along.
It was nice to have the option of getting some more background, some more context to see how something was done, hear a little bit about what the artist was trying, what they thought they were doing.
Now in the past, we've had exhibitions and we've put multimedia on the outside. Here we actually try to figure out a way that we could incorporate that direct experience of the artists, talking about their work. Who does a visitor want to hear more when they're standing in front of an artwork than the artist who created it?
These animals protect each other. They all fit within each other. But the spider is a very lonely creature. Of course, she's very strong.
The iPad Gallery
invade.
Explorer is a way that people can
she
carry the artist
power.
Around with them
she
as they go through the exhibition.
The whole house. So there is a similarity between the spider and my mother.
The best ones were actually when you saw the artist speaking directly, like getting sort of big sticks and some painting from a distance.
With ink and a stick, you get a lot of accidents. So you start getting a drip.
So how he sort of painted it and how he's following dribbles down the page and stuff. And
you take the stick to follow the drip and push the drip in another direction. You're making a line. So it's like accident, correction.
And it also, you know, came across as being a much more spontaneous picture.
Listening and watching the video, then, you know, seeing the artwork right close by, I got, you know, better insight into the grid system that Chuck Close uses in his painting.
Once the grid is made, I have to see where the beat of the grid falls across the information.
In particular, the Chuck Close video that's available on the smart tables and also on the handheld device, you see Chuck Close actually working on the portrait. You see it in the background, you see how he holds the brush, how he creates the individual cells of his grid, and I think it's immensely satisfying and really adds a lot to understanding what the work's about. Oh. One of the things that's excited me about viewing visitors in the galleries is seeing how many people use the smart tables. People were really engaged with the smart tables, doing the activities, and talking to one another about the activity they were doing.
Well, the whole concept of this floor is a revelation for me. I don't tend to think of art in these ways. And so the idea of grid or language as art is very appealing and very new to me.
In the rear of the exhibition, at the end of the show, after visitors have gone through all six galleries, all six themes, and watched potentially curators describing how they came up with these six different themes, visitors can sit down and make their own gallery, drawing from all of these six different galleries that they've seen, any artwork they want, and put them together. We think that's really important, and we really want to see how our visitors are experiencing and making sense of and making meaning out of the artwork in our collection.
So what do we learn from Points of Departure? Quite a lot. We learned that we can put computers in the gallery and they can work very well, and we can still have an extremely elegant installation that people love. We learned that we want to keep doing this kind of show. We learned that our audience loves it. Kids, adults, members, school groups, college classes. It's been an extremely popular show.